Mark here with Eastwood. Today on the R&D Corner, we're going to talk about MIG welders. What we're going to do is test our MIG 135 against Lincoln's SP140. But a bunch of you guys also had some questions about sheet metal work. So what we're going to do is show you some of the tools that we have and some of the tips and techniques. So let's get started. What we got here now is Lincoln's SP140T. This is a tap wound transformer. So you have your five different volt settings here, and then your infinite wire speed adjustment on there. What we did was we set everything up as per the instructions inside the unit. You saw that for the sheet metal. And also we're gonna go ahead, do the same T weld on the 1/8 plate. Now this is a true MIG type unit here. It's DC rectified. So let's go ahead, test this guy out. All right, the stitch welding went real nice on it. Trigger, drive motor real nice, can complete a couple stitches. That's what I would have done coming across this seam here. But we wanted to run some beads just to see if we would get any burn through, which it did not, which is good. Just did little half inch guys there. And then on the plate, looks like got good penetration here. It was just on the settings, had to turn wire speed up a little bit more, and to get it to burn in there, just had to do like little C motions coming through here. Now let's check out the Eastwood welder. All right, what we got here is the Eastwood MIG 135. Like the Lincoln, this is a rectified DC output machine, good to 135 amps, has continuous wound transformer, which instead of just your five preset settings, you have infinite voltage control here from about 20 to 135 amp. Same thing with the wire speed. So let's go ahead. As per the chart, we're setting this up. E4 is the starting point for the sheet metal, so we'll go ahead and do that and then get right into the 1/8 plate. Same thing, looks at least visually looks pretty equivalent to the Lincoln. Got our stitch welds over here, a couple little short beads. Looks like we got the penetration in there. Just had to go, all I had to do was tweak it from the initial setting in the instruction book was an I6. Just had to tweak the wire speed up, and then again, like the nice thing is you can go between your volt adjustments on this one here, whereas the Lincoln one you only had A, B, C, D, E, 5 points on here. So that was a nice little tweak that could get you in there. Feature for feature, these things are about identical, this unit being about half the price. So click the link below to buy now. All right, first product I want to show you is our pinch weld clamps. These things are a must-have for any auto body work. What you can see we have here is just clamping these two strips together for a butt weld. Tremendous clamping pressure. These things are great on rear fenders, holding the inner fender lip to the outer for the spot welds in there. All right, the next one are inner grips. These things have been a staple in the sheet metal industry for years. Basically what you have is two pieces to this tool here. I have two of them already on the panel. These are what you want to use for butt welding. Let's say that this may have been a lower skin on a door, or you're hanging a full replacement quarter. Go ahead and set the approximate gap. put this piece in the rear. Now about the only place they're not going to work is on rockers, where you're going to end up with a closed box. You won't be able to retrieve this part, but on any of the other panels or bench work, this is perfect. So go ahead, it comes in a kit of four. I only need three of them on here. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and tack a couple of these on here. There you go, we put a couple tacks on this. As you can see, the gap created and held by these intergrips is the perfect gap for the 023 MIG wire going down there. You'll be able to just put a couple spots in there and then stitch weld this whole seam. What you saw there was our spot weld kit. What this does, this kit gives you these forked pliers here, which clamp the two pieces. This is great for right down on rockers, any type of pinch weld that you have. And this nozzle is designed with these two standoffs here. Fits right in between the fork there. What it does is it gives you the consistent standoff distance from your tip to the material, so that each one of your spot welds is going to be duplicated and equivalent on down there. It'll give you a nice look of just like the OE resistance welds. So let's do a couple more. Two quick tips for you. First off, when welding this seam, what we want to do is prevent any kind of warpage. So you can't just start at one side and just think you're going to run a continuous bead across here. This metal is going to move on you like there's nothing. So what we want to do is stitch welding. Stitch welding is basically taking the gun, zap, holding this trigger for a second, moving to the next area. Come back, zap, zap, second at a time. I'll show you. So what you want to do is continue to move around your panel so that you disperse the heat out there. Once you start getting close, you're going to have to wait a little bit longer for it to cool. Second thing, this panel here, it's no problem to get your ground clip on here. What you want to do with MIG welding is get your ground as close to your work area. So areas where you might be doing a floorboard, you can't clamp onto anything here. Just take a common bolt, go ahead and weld him onto the piece. Trick though, only weld one of the six flats. That'll give you a nice solid electrical ground, but then it'll also let you come by with a hammer, simply break it right off. So let's stitch a little bit of this seam here, show you what you mean. All right, so we showed you some of the tools that we offer that make sheet metal work easy, and it is. A little bit of practice, you'll be hanging quarters. We also showed you our unit against the Lincoln unit. Feature for feature, these things are about identical, this unit being about half the price. So click the link below to buy now.